Hello again, people. What you can see up in front of the camera there is the pin arrangement for an MK Commando 63 amp single phase plug. Okay. The details on it is let me hold on a moment. It's a K9063. 6 hour, and that is 200 to 250 volts. IP44 on that plug, and in today's video, we're going to be wiring it up. Okay, if I zoom that camera out now, there's a little something next to that. I said out, not in. Okay, there it is. That is an IP67 socket for that plug. Okay. Now, before I wire it up, there's going to be a few people asking me. That's if you haven't seen the other videos. What do I want with a plug and socket that big? Well, allow me just to let you in on a little something, people. That socket that you see up in front of the camera there. In another video, I said that I went to my stockist and asked them on a quote how much they would charge me for the 32 amp version of that socket you see up in front of the camera there. Okay, that's the 63 amp one, but I asked them. Because, like I say, I don't have any use for a socket that size. So I said to them, how much would you charge me for a 32 amp version? So, a little few, clicky clack on the computer keyboard, and he brought the price up. And he said to me, including VAT, the 32 amp version of that is £110. Okay. And yeah, that is a lot of cash. And basically speaking, I haven't got £110 sitting around doing nothing. So I said to my stockist, "Well, I'll think about that one another day," and then promptly left the store a bit half sharpish. Yeah, so I come home and getting the old computer out and going on the internet, I headed straight over to that well-known popular auction website, and I managed to get that. Okay, and I got it on a massive discount. Okay, if you want to know how much of a massive discount I got that for, and how much those sockets normally sell for. Because I did manage to find one other general website where someone was selling one of those at its full price as well. Yeah, so if you want to know how much I got that socket for up in front of the camera there, look in the video description and there's a link to when I bought that socket. Okay. Yeah, and once you see how much I paid for that socket, then you will know why I got the 63 amp one and not the 32. Okay. Yes, normally speaking, the 63 amp is significantly more expensive than the 32 amp one. But like I say, I got that one on a massive discount. Okay. Same with the plug. Okay. Those plugs are about £35. And yeah, I got that one also on the popular auction website on a big discount too. So there we go. So for 5 minutes, here's what I'm going to do with that plug. I'm going to take that socket away just for the meanwhile. We'll be bringing it back in a little bit later on in the video. Rightio. While I'm talking to you about that plug, I'm going to be knocking up a brew because it's cup of tea time again. tea time. It's almost there, people. So, that plug. What do I want with a 63 amp plug? Well, look, I've already said I've got the socket for it on a massive discount, significantly cheaper than a 32 amp version. Okay. Our house has got a 60 amp electrical service in it. That plug up in front of the camera there is 63 amps, so technically I could get the whole house on that plug. Amazing but true. Now, I don't have anything which would draw that much current, and I also do not have an electrical service into which I could wire that socket that we've just seen. But, in another video, I was saying about putting in a specialist 32 amp socket out in the garden, wasn't I? Then I went to my stockist and found out how much they wanted for, that socket, that 32 amp IP67 socket, and they quoted me £110, including VAT. I've not got £110 sitting around doing nothing, people. And I can feel it coming on. It's almost a cup of tea time. So, like I say, got that socket on a big discount, and I needed a plug to go with it. Got the plug at a big discount too. Massive, massive bonus. I'm bringing home the flavour, people. So, the service that I wanted out in the garden was a 32 amp service. This means only one thing. I am going to have to make up a converter. So, cup of tea time is now served. And we're going to wire that plug. Because I only want 32 amp and that's a 63 amp, what I'm going to do basically is when I install the specialist circuit for that socket, I'm only going to put it on a 32 amp service. Okay? It'll be a 63 amp socket, but it'll only have 32 amp capacity on it. So, on that note, I have got a coupler. That's a 32 amp one. Okay. I'm going to have a short length of flex coming out of that plug and going into there. Okay, so I'm going to make it down basically a downsizer so that I can put that plug in, the big old beefy 63 amp socket. And then, I can bring it down to the 32 amp size. And if we look on the kitchen floor, into that coupler, I can then connect this. There it is. That there is, you've got a 32 amp plug, a 32 amp coupler, and that there is a roll of 4mm cross-sectional area, 32 amp flex, 10 meters in length. Okay, that is why I want that 32 amp socket, so I can put that plug into the socket. But like I say, £110, people, I ain't having it. So I went as a bit of a cross between beggars can't be choosers and don't look a gift horse in the mouth. I managed to get a 63 amp socket on a big discount, so I needed a 63 amp plug like that one to go into it. The only thing being is I now need to make a downsizer. Looking on the internet, I managed to find a stockist which would sell me only 1 meter, because that's all I need, 1 meter of 63 amp flex. Okay, is it off? Well, I do believe it's actually 74 amps you can put through it. And it is 16mm cross-sectional area, okay, and out of all honesty, if you get the flex, okay, and you measure across it the diameter, right, the piece of 16mm, right, it is about 23mm in diameter across. It is ridiculously huge. Okay, although they haven't got a picture of it on the website, they've obviously measured it and they've put the details on their website. And, yeah. That plug would accept a cable that size. I would have to cut that rubber bung out a bit to get it in there. But it would obviously accept a cable 16mm cross-sectional area, which is 23mm in diameter. The small problem with that is I wouldn't get the other end of that flex in there. It just wouldn't go. I would have to make that hole a bit bigger. But the cord clamp in that would not, because I've already measured it up, it would not accept a cable which is 23mm in diameter, which is a little disappointing, really. So we're going to have to be a little bit naughty, okay? That short piece of flex I've got up in front of the camera there, it is the same size as that one down there. And that is 4mm, that. Okay, 4mm. 32 amp. Like I said, I'm only going to be wiring that socket on a 32 amp service anyway. And I'm only going to be using that plug in that socket. Okay. So that's what I'm going to do. Interestingly enough, and it's something I should have done really, I should have looked at either the 6mm size cable flex or the 10mm size to see whether I could get the end of one of those in there. Yeah, I should have done that. But again, prices. And the fact that I'm only going to be putting that into a socket which is on the 32 amp service anyway, I've decided not to get the larger sized flex, because you know, the price of it was well, 1 meter length of I think 16mm was like about £10 or £12. And the thing is, I'm not going to be pulling 63 amps through it anyway, so it was a bit pointless me getting a cable that size. Waffle, waffle, waffle. Right. Let's open up our 63 amp plug. In another video, I've done a detailed disassembly of this plug. So if you want to see what the terminals are in this, what they do, how they do it, why they do it, look in the video description, and I'll probably put a link in there, or the detailed video of this blog is quite recently added on my video list, or you can always go to the plugs playlist and find that video bit on the manual side. So we've got our cord clamp there. When you're putting your flex in, like I said in other videos, make sure you get the correct end, okay? Because if you get the wrong end in the plug, you've got to basically cross the conductors over and interweave them and this, that and the other and all the rest of it to get them to go to their respective terminals. And it doesn't really do the flex that much good. Okay, when you get the correct end, you strip it back and those three conductors more or less make their own way to their respective terminals. And that's how you want it. So I'm going to release that cord clamp, because it's a bit in the way. We can add that on later. Okay, you can actually take those screws right out, or because the other end is loose, I can threadle that up through that, no trouble at all. Okay, on this occasion, but on other occasions there may be a big appliance on that end, so you can't get that appliance through that cord clamp. Taking a suitably sized screwdriver for the terminals. Okay, we've got two different sizes there. Okay, I'll use this little wee one to undo those screws, but this one I'm going to use this on the terminals. And I'm going to loosen our terminals off. Look at those big, beefy, chunky brass screws. That's nice, people. I do like big, chunky brass screws. Just loosen those screws off. Okay, well, that's about there. Again, these terminals on the back here, you can put 16mm cross-sectional area conductors in there. But on this occasion, because I'm only going to be putting this plug into a 32 amp rated service, I'm only going to be putting 32 amp cable in. It's a bit naughty, but like I say, that plug is going to be going into that socket only. And yeah, generally speaking, in unskilled hands, this converter I'm making up, it would be a bit naughty, because that there, it's only 32 amp, and it's unfused, as would be the plug that it goes into. And yeah, you could imagine that tugging 63 amps out of that. Not that you could, because this plug's going to be going into a socket which has only got a 32 amp circuit breaker on it anyway. So I'm just looking at the ends of them flexes to see if I can get the corresponding conductors to line up to the terminals. Okay, you can see the green and yellow up the top there. That one's a blue for neutral, and the brown one for live. There's our earth terminal there, and there's a live terminal there. So if I offer that up, that's the wrong end. So we're going to go for the other end. That's the correct end then. Yep. This end is the end that I'm going to strip back. So I'm going to take a sharp knife and just basically get into it, get in there. Okay, when I'm stripping, because I've only got a short length of flex, when I'm stripping that back, I'm going to start stripping a little bit off. And if that's not enough, I'm going to strip a bit more off, until we get the correct length. Okay, normally speaking, what you can do, if you take too much off, you can snip a bit off the end, but that is wasteful. So, I'm just going to have a quick look at that, and then I'm going to start stripping this piece of flex back. 4mm flex, this is 32 amp. Like I say, putting a 32 amp flex into a 63 amp plug, it is a bit naughty. But, as I've already established in this video, that plug will only be going into a socket, which is on a 32 amp circuit anyway, so I don't need to worry about overloading that flex and having flames. We don't want flames. Well, not on this occasion anyway, and certainly not from that plug and that socket in the flex. Okay, chances are a little bit later on in some fun videos, this piece of flex will be supplying current to a fun video, and somewhere a bit further down the line, there will be flames, deliberately and intentionally, and just for the laughs and giggles. But we don't want flames at that point. Okay, so I'll strip the ends back, and well, there we go. So, as you can see, if I offer that up, you can see those conductors, I'll just put them, there you go, they more or less made their own way. You see what I'm talking about? They've more or less made their own way to their own terminals without being crossed over and interwoven and goodness knows what else. Okay. So there you go. Now, unfortunately, people, there comes a time when I'm out of time, basically. I've only had about 20 minutes on the memory card, and yeah, it's just about to run out, so I'm going to have to go for a change on the memory card. Yeah, so I'm going to say little commercial break, I reckon. We'll have a little commercial break, and straight after that, we'll come back and get this little lot wired up. And yeah, we'll carry on with it. And well, there it is. Okay, so just going to wind this up, look at the progress so far. Strip that in back to that 63 amp plug. We'll put the coupler on in part two, in section two. And yeah, don't move straight after this, after the commercial break. Oh, people, you're back. Okay then, right. This is section two of trying to get that 63 amp NK commando plug wired. Over in front of the camera there, you can see that there's some exposed conductors, and I have been busy stripping back some appliance flex. In section one, I whipped that off the end, and it turns out that wasn't long enough, so I've whipped another piece off. Okay, so overall it's that length I've whipped off. And the reason why I whipped off that much is because those big beefy conductors are terminals on that 63 amp plug. They do need a nice good chunky amount of conductor to bite into. As you can see there in front of the camera, I've stripped all three ends back and the neutral and live have been doubled over. The earth one, I've yet to do that because I've got a little tip to show you. It's cup of tea time again. Out of all honesty, that is the cup of tea which was in section one. Okay. Now, little bit top tip when stripping back conductors, especially when you're taking that much insulation off. I'm just going to move this over here. Okay, it is easy to do this because I've only got a short length of flex, but when you're stripping back conductors, especially that much, it is a bit difficult to basically twist the conductors together. I think I've got the zoom on. Yeah, I've got the zoom on. It's a bit difficult to twist the conductors together that long. So instead of like starting there and twisting it and twisting it and twisting it all the way along, what I've done, because I've only got a short length of flex, is I'm pinching the end like that, holding it like that, and then just rotating the whole thing in the direction that the strands lay, like that, and that then binds them all together, okay, making sure that you turn the whole thing in the correct direction in which the strands lay. Okay, if you do it the other way, you make a fantastic pig's ear of it. Okay, there we go, all nicely twisted together now. Is the camera getting on that? Hopefully it is. But those ones, you can see I've doubled them over. So, when I was stripping that back, the first one that I'd done was the live conductor, as indicated by the two pieces of insulation there. You see I've done the neutral in one big piece and the earth in one big piece. Again, it is easier to do in two sections. Whip one piece off and then whip the other piece off. How I determined that I needed that much conductor strip back is on the plug. You can see the two terminals there. So I offered the conductor up to the terminal like that. And then I pinched my thumbnail there and I thought to myself, I need to strip that much off. Okay, and if I look at that, you can see it is that length. Okay, then I thought to myself, being big chunky industrial terminals like that, they might want a nice big bit of conductor to bite into. So I stripped off double the length like that, doubled it over like that. So I've yet to do that with the earth one. And now I've twisted all the strands together, I'm going to just offer that half of insulation up to that, like that. Okay, that there's a halfway point, then pinch that with my thumbnail there and double it over, and surely enough that is a proper act of precision, because you know that BoomBox Deluxe has got flavour. Okay, a little bit of time equals a lot of precision. Okay, wire it once and wire it properly. That's what I say. Okay, that is a 4mm 32 amp flex, and I'm putting it into a 63 amp plug. It's a bit naughty. In section one, however, I did determine and verify that the 63 amp plug will be going into a socket which is only wired on the 32 amp service anyway. So, in a way, I can sort of get away with doing that little bit of naughtiness. offering our completed strands up to the plug, you will find that the conductors more or less make their own way to their own respective terminals. Okay, I'm just going to open those earth terminal up a bit more. Okay, there we go. They're now wide open. Again, don't loosen those terminal screws off too much, because it is really annoying, especially if you're on a mucky building site, if the screw drops out and it goes walkabout. Okay, if you cannot recover the screw, you then got a plug, which has not got a terminal screw in it, and those are expensive. Okay, so yeah, don't loosen those terminal screws off too much. Lock off of those conductors up, and hopefully without too much faffing around, they should just glide straight in there. There we go. Okay, they're all in their respective holes, like that. No exposed conductor sticking out, because we don't want that. And now I'm going to proceed to tighten up those big, beefy, chunky terminals. There we go, that is plenty of conductor for those terminal screws to bite into, thus ensuring a good solid electrical connection, because that's what we want, people. Nice good solid electrical connection. And being 32 amp flex, I'm pretty sure at some point or another, somewhere in the future, I am going to be pulling 32 amps out of that at 240 volts. Let's do up that other one, that earth conductor. Very important that, because if you've got something connected onto the other end of that flex, which is class 1, it's that earthing conductor which stops the metal case of the class 1 appliance from becoming live. There we go, I've tightened up all those terminals now. Like so. There they all are, no exposed conductors sticking out. So that is a proper wholesome job right there. You're probably wondering where that cord clamp is. There it is. Now, because I haven't got anything on the other end of that flex, I can then just loosen that cord clamp off and slide it down over the flex. You can get these screws. Where's that camera? You can get these screws and remove them right out and separate those two pieces of cord clamp and put it on that way if you had an appliance on the other end of that flex. Okay, but I'm just going to loosen this off enough so that I can get our piece of 4mm cross-sectional area flex down inside that cord clamp. Okay, right, I think that'll be enough. Okay, you don't want to loosen these things off too much, because, as like anything like this, if you loosen it right off, you only got to tighten it all the way back up again. And that takes time, people. So, I reckon we'll get a 4mm flex through that gap. And look at that, plop. So, let's turn it around. Again, I've got to bend it downwards, camera. I've got to bend it downwards in order to locate those little lugs in those holes. And then lift it upright, basically. So, lug goes in that hole. Lug goes in the other hole. And then we just lift it upright. Okay, is it going to go? Yes, it is. Well, it's got to. Okay, and then once it's in the upright position like that, you then proceed to tighten those screws. Okay, what I will do is I will grab hold of that outer sheath and push it down a bit so that you've got a bit of slack on those conductors. Okay, like that, and I've given it a minor twist, only very slightly, like that, and you've got a bit of slack on those conductors. And now I'll pinch that cord clamp like that and proceed to tighten it up. Another little important note to note about this, if you've already figured it out, is if you did have an appliance on the other end of that flex, it is very important, of course, to put that over the flex before you wire that on there. Okay, because if you've just done what I've just done, and you've got an appliance on that end, you're not going to be getting your appliance through that hole. Okay, in order to, do the, finish the plug job. There it is. That is now complete on there. And because I haven't got an appliance on the other end, I can do this. Taking our cover, and then just put the flex through, like so. And then making sure a little notch is lined up on the plug, all the way down. Right, there's our little notch just in there. Put that on like that. Now, you've probably noticed that in this plug, I did not wire up the pilot contact. This is because this plug is going to be used in a mechanically interlocked socket. And it will probably be only used in that mechanically interlocked socket anyway. And to a certain degree, not wiring up the pilot contact is a bit of an advantage. That's a bit of a squeaky one, that one. I think there's a mouse in there. Right, there we go. Yeah, not wiring up that pilot contact is a bit of an advantage because, not that this plug is going to find its way into other hands, but if it did, and it's only got 32 amp appliance flex on it, if someone put that into an electrically interlocked socket which needed the pilot contact to activate it, they'd put the plug in and nothing would happen. Okay? So that would actually safeguard that flex on that plug from being overloaded, basically. Like I say, and I'll say it again, this plug is going to be put into a socket which is on the 32 amp service. So therefore I can, although it's a bit naughty, I can get away with wiring it up with only 4mm flex. Up in front of the camera there then, for 13 minutes, I've wired up 63 amp plug. Yeah. So we've got that on there. What I would say is, when you're making up extension cords, right, little top tip, because I've kind of gone and done it again, haven't I? When you're making up your extension cords, wire the socket on first, okay? Because if at this point I had to shoot off somewhere and do something else, what you've got up in front of the camera there is something which is potentially dangerous, because you've got a plug on that end and nothing on that end, okay? Like I say, this plug isn't going to find its way into other hand, but you can see what's going to happen there. Put that in the wall socket, and that's got exposed conductive ends on it, which is pretty naughty. But if you wired the wired the socket on, and you had to go off somewhere else and do something, it wouldn't be that hazardous, because you would just have a socket on one end and exposed ends on the other, and there's no danger with that. So when you're making up your extension cords, wire on the socket first. And then if you've got to go off and come back and do the plug, then so be it. It'll be much safer. But on this occasion, it's only me here, and it's only going to be me using this. So, you know. But yeah, it's a little top tip from me. Wire your socket on first, and then your plug. Cup of tea. So, next up, we're going to get this put on there, and there we go, we're in for 15 minutes again. These ones twist and just open like so. I'm pretty sure that I've already done a video wiring these up, because if we look down on the kitchen floor, I've wired up the plug equivalent of this, and there it is, all the way down there. There it is. That there is the plug equivalent of the coupler that I'm just about to wire up. Okay, and it is that plug, where's my finger, it is that plug which is going to go into that coupler. Okay. So let's zoom that camera out now. That extension cord, because it is an extension cord, there's another coupler there. That one's a Ludin Palazzoli. 32 amp plug and coupler on there with 4mm 32 amp flex, 10 meters in length. There it is. But we're going to be wiring a coupler onto that piece of flex. And, well, is that 60? Yeah, 16 minutes in. I'll tell you what. Do a commercial break and we'll come back for section 3. Okay, so see you in a minute. It's section 3, people. And what you can see up in front of the camera there is the already stripped back end of that 32 amp, 4mm cross-sectional area flex. And there's a coupler up in front of the camera there with a screwdriver. And what I've got in my hand is a cup of tea time again. It's the same cup of tea as what was in section 2 and section 1. So, this is section 3, after a little commercial break there. Strip the ends back, ready for our coupler there. Before I strip that end back, because the other end of that flex is already occupied, I have put the cord clamp on, and most importantly, of course, I have put on the back section of the coupler, because I won't be able to put that on after I wired it up, because on the other end of the flex we have got, as we already know from section 1 and section 2, we've got that whopping great 63 amp plug, okay, because we're making a downsizer, okay, and yeah, it's now just a case of get those three terminals done up and put those conductors in, people. I think I've already loosened them off. That earth one needs loosening off a bit more, using an appropriately sized screwdriver, of course. There we are. Once again, when stripping your ends back, always set the choose the correct end so that when you offer those conductors up, they find their own way, more or less, to their respective terminals, okay, because you don't want them interwoven and this, that, and the other, and all the rest of it, and jiggly pokery, and hocus pocus, okay, because it's not good for them, and it looks a mess, okay, so there you go, they've made their own way to their respective terminals, and I'm now going to tighten those screws up. Do the earth one first. Tweaky, tweaky. Between section 2 and section 3, I obviously speeded the process up a bit by getting the ends prepared. Because, as you know, in section 2, it was just the ends unprepared. There we go, it's a live one done up. One more to do, and then we can snap that coupler closed. If I can find the terminal screw, it's around here somewhere. Where are you? That rumbling sound is that 63 amp plug scraping around on the kitchen worktop. Is that it? There it is, right in there. See, look, you've got the two terminal screws right next to each other. That one does live, which is just there, but that hole there does neutral, which is right over the other side. Oh, come on, MK, what were you thinking when you done that? Right the way in there, right the way up the back there. There we go. That's that done. I should have known that because I've already wired up one of these 32 amp couplers on another little electrical job. But there we go. Once again, no exposed conductors on that. You don't want that. But yeah, those conductors are more or less making their own way to their respective terminals. And now, where's that cord clamp gone? Pull that down. Yeah, you've got to flat that down to get it on there. Like that. That one in there, that one in there. Lift it up and tighten it up. Once again, I'm going to, like I did in the 63 amp socket, push that down a little bit, that outer sheath. It's a little bit difficult to do this. Look what I've got to contend with here. All this hocus pocus on here. So I'm going to push that down a bit and then get that cord clamp done up. There we go. Just to put a little bit of slack on those conductors. There we are. That's all clamped up. That's a proper little job, that. Stand it upright. There we go. A little bit of slack on those conductors so they're not pulled and tugged and whatnot. And then you just slide the back section of the coupler over all that assembly. And clip it locked. So it goes on there like that. And then that part there goes into that little notch there. Job done. And what we got there up in front of the camera, if I can just arrange that flex nicely, it's got a funny little curvature in it for some reason, and I ain't having it. Right. There it is then. There's our downsizer. Right there. 63 amp plug on one end, 32 amp coupler on the other, with a piece of 4mm cross-sectional area flex in the middle. Okay, like I was saying in, I can't remember if it's section 1 or section 2, I have not wired the pilot contact in that 63 amp plug because in the application that I'm going to be using it, that plug is only going to be going into a mechanically interlocked socket, so therefore, really speaking, the pilot contact isn't needed. And I don't really see that downsizer falling into wrong hands, but if someone, you know, if that does ever happen and someone puts that 63 amp plug into an electrically interlocked socket, nothing will happen, okay? Because the pilot contact is not wired up, therefore it will probably safeguard that small piece of 4mm flex on there. At a later date, should I manage to source a piece of either 6mm or 10mm flex, and I can get either a 6 or a 10 into that 32 amp coupler, then I will change that piece of flex out and put something on there a little bit more beefy. Okay, because that flex on there can only take 32 amp, and I think I've already established the fact that that plug is going to be going into a 63 amp socket, of which is only wired on the 32 amp surface anyway. Okay, so you know, not too much of a problem there, and that is how I can bend the rules a little bit and put a flex on that plug which is smaller than what it should be. Okay, because that flex will it won't take 63 amps. Yeah, but like I say, that downsizer set is going to be going. It's for my use only, basically. Pop. There it is. That is the mechanically interlocked 63 amp IP67 socket. And that is for that downsizer up in front of the camera there. Okay, I'm going to put everything on the floor because we're now going to get a little mock-up test going, a little mock-up connection set up. Let's wind this camera down a bit. Okay, let's see if I can get this in for 10 minutes. I doubt it, but there's nothing like trying. I'm just going to swing that camera around there a minute. Right. Oh, 9 minutes and 55. Right. So, if we could imagine the setup out in the garden for 10 minutes, this is what I was going to do, and I've just done it up in front of the down there on the floor. We're just going to swing the camera around, and we have to look at the little setup. Okay. So to start with, then we've got our if you could imagine it as an outside socket. There it is. Okay, that'll be outside in the garden, so to speak, and plugged into that we've got our 63 amp plug. Okay, firing that down a bit, and that then downsizes to that 32 amp coupler. Okay, and then into that I can then put in our 32 amp plug. Okay, and then we've got our extension cord, and that coupler all the way over there, we can put in our, I think we all know what's going to go on that, and there it is, people. That's basically it. Okay, let's pull that camera back so we can see the whole setup, and I think that's quite nice, actually. It's properly satisfying. Right, zoom right the way out. Pull that camera back. There it is. That's the whole setup. Right there. There it is. 64 amp plug and socket there. Comes out, downsizes to the 32 amp size. There's our roll of extension cord there. And I think we all know what's going to go on that coupler there. So, for 12 minutes and 3 seconds, people, thanks for watching.